Welcome back to Speller Tutorial Services. Today we're going to talk about polar coordinates. Polar coordinate is defined with the ordered pair r theta, where r is the radius and theta is the angle created by the radius. And we're going to see how that relates to rectangular coordinates, which are shown with the ordered pair xy, where x is your horizontal movement and y is your vertical movement. All right, to show this relationship, we're going to start off by drawing a Cartesian coordinate plane, and we're going to place a unit circle on that plane. All right, with the Cartesian coordinate plane, we know that we have two axes. This here, the horizontal would be the x-axis, and the vertical is the y-axis. And now we're going to draw a unit circle on this Cartesian coordinate plane. All right, this is called the unit circle because the radius of this circle is just one unit, and we'll get more definition as we continue to draw. All right, so here, this point on the circle, if this is one unit out, would be 1, 0, one unit to the right, and I didn't move up or down. Up here, this would be 0, +1. Back here, a -1, 0. And this point down here is at 0, -1. So now I've got the four points on the circle. Now let's say there's a radius r that extends from the center of the circle to the edge of the circle and touches the circle there, and we draw a vertical line that creates a right angle. That vertical line says the base of the triangle created is x and the height or the altitude is y, and that also gives us a definition for the point that touches the circle, and that point is at xy. Being that we have a right triangle here, the relationship that's created is that x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared, which is just the Pythagorean theorem. So if we're given x and y, we can actually compute what the radius is. Now let's take these rectangular figures or these rectangular coordinates that we have and convert those into polar coordinates. And also I want to make sure that I said that the angle created by radius r, it creates this angle here called theta. So let's start off by finding what the cosine of theta is. We know the relationship defined by cosine is the adjacent side over the hypotenuse. So that would be x over r. And if we were to express this in terms of x, we just cross multiply, and that says that x is equal to r cosine theta. Now let's take a look at sine of theta. Sine theta is the relationship of the opposite side over the hypotenuse, so that would be y over r. And if I wanted to express that in terms of y, again I cross multiply and I come up with y is equal to r sine theta. And now let's take a look at tangent of theta. The relationship that exists with tangent is opposite over adjacent, in this case y over x. And if I wanted to figure out what theta is, I say that theta is equal to the arctangent of y over x to find that. All right, so that sums it up for this short video on polar coordinates. Please stay tuned to Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube page. Thank you for watching.